Okay, can you hear me out there?
Yeah.
I'm back there in the middle. This is Tuba Christmas 2016. It is the 16th year that we have done this. The first few years, we were at Jezebel's downtown, and that isn't in existence anymore. And we moved up here, I think, 5 years ago. I'm not sure when the fire was, but we moved up here. If you're new to this, like Boyd Beaton Boy is out there, these are tubas and baritones, or tubas and euphoniums, if you like. They're in all sorts of different pitches and keys, and they're very interesting. There's sousaphones over there on your left, like you would march with. There's tubas here in the back row, and the baritones are the smaller ones in front. This is an international. You could, if you were in Malaysia, you probably could go to a Tuba Christmas. And it was developed, Tuba Christmas was developed by a guy named Harvey Phillips. And Harvey Phillips decided he needed some sort of a device to raise the standard of these two instruments, who were kind of looked at as a joke. And clearly you can see how serious we are up here. There's no jokes about us. But anyway, that was the point, and it works. And the music, you're going to find some of the prettiest arrangements of Christmas carols that you probably have ever heard. And if you can, the words aren't in your word sheet. I think you all have a lyric sheet with you. The words are not on Old Christmas Tree, but Janet, I imagine they all can sing it anyway. So Janet will bring you in the second time and go ahead and sing with us. So it's Old Christmas Tree or Old Tannenbaum.
Just make up the words.
Where we are, go up an octave, or I suppose you could go down an octave if you were in Russia, but let's not do that. Let's just say you do whatever you want to do, and if you sing wrong, there'll probably be some people along with you on that. So just sing nice and loud, and enjoy yourself. So here is A Way in a Man.
Thank you. isn't it, to find that pitch? I'm all over the place until I finally...
They sounded good though, Jenny.
They sound great.
Yeah, I mean, we could hear their voices way back here. They sounded good. Yeah. I've done this 16 years now here in Newberry, and about 3 years ago, I retired, and I'm no longer the band director here as a low brass instructor. And most of the management of this, except for talking and playing, most of the management of this has gone to John Fulmer, a Mid-Carolina high school graduate, a Newberry College graduate. John is a wonderful saxophone player and also plays wonderful tuba. And he has taken over pretty much the doing of all of this. He does all the legwork, takes care of all the computer stuff, et cetera, et cetera. And in a sense, this is John Fulmer's Tuba Christmas instead of Bill Long's. And if you don't know who he is, he's standing up right now. He's an incredible band director. John was at Newberry Middle School for 3 years, and now for 2 years has been at Latta High School up in the PD and doing a fine job up there. There's a whole bunch of folks here that either took lessons from me or were in my band up here on the stage. If you took lessons from me or were in my band or one of my ensembles, would you please stand up right now? And we talk about heartwarming when I walk in and see these guys, it just I'm about in tears half the time. It's just wonderful. So here is God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. And somebody's going to be disappointed if I don't tell them the story about this. There was a TV show called $64,000 Question. And Dr. Joyce Brothers, I think, is the one that got the answer. And the answer to the question is, where is the comma in God Rest You Merry Gentlemen? And I think she won like $32,000 or something, which was big bucks back in those days. And the comma is after Mary. So it's God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. So here we are. Let's go. Piano, they sing on this one. Right on the first time.
No.
Nope.
We repeat it. Yep. Oh, we repeat it? Oh, yeah. Remember, guys, that we reached back to the first time.
Good thing he has me.
Giving out gifts and so on. Anyway, It's an interesting thing, Tuba Christmas is. It involves a lot of middle-aged, young, and old people. And our youngest person is over on your left in the tuba section with a tuba that is exactly her size, Miss Margaret Rose, who is 14. Yeah. And as Eugene Long says to his brother Bill, the only reason I come to these things is so that you don't have to be the oldest, because I would be if it weren't for our good friend from Chapin, Eugene Long, on baritone. So Eugene, you get to tell us how old.
Yeah.
81, and the youngest is 14. That's cool. All right. So here we go with the King of Bohemia, and everybody, we're on Good King Wenceslas.
Can we start singing right away? Okay. Good luck finding that.
First time,
Janet.
Oh, he sings. That's it.
in those 16 years since it's been here, or been in Newberry, there's a handful of people, including myself, that have never, ever, 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 ever missed one. Now, I don't know, Gordon and Audrey, have you been to all of them, guys?
Yes, we have.
I thought so, starting clear down. Anyway, not only have Gordon and Audrey been to all of them, their son, who was in Lorraine Paris's band here at Newberry High School years and years and years ago, was a euphonium major at Indiana University. Correct, Gordon?
That is true.
And played with the famous Harvey Phillips in the Tuba Christmas. And Gordon brought me a clipping from a newspaper showing him. And Gordon and Audrey, would you please stand up and take a round of applause? We appreciate it. Of the players up here, some of the folks have gotten to most of them. I think John missed one. I think that I think Kim missed one because of Christmas parades back in the day. But Payne, in addition to Janet and myself, have been here forever. This is Payne Seal over on your right. Never missed. And in the back, standing up for a second time, never, ever, ever, ever missed, Deb Wells. And I was going to have Wanda Lee stand up, who's always at these things. She isn't here. But if she comes in, I'll announce her also. So here we go with It Came Upon the Midnight Flare. And yes, this is probably one of my favorites. If it is not number one, it's pretty close. This is a fabulous arrangement of it. It's hard for the baritones to play that high through the whole thing, but it's just gorgeous. So as you sing, be listening too. Here's It Came Upon the Midnight Flare.
Can we come in right away?
Remember, we're only going two times. Is that what she just said?
Yes.
Being hard of hearing, is it?
Okay.
key signature. It's our first time we're doing that E flat thing. Don't miss it. I'll give you six.
Bill Bell was Harvey Phillips' teacher and maybe one of the most profound musicians, even though most of you have never heard of him, one of the most profound musicians of the last 150 years. He was a tuba player, played in the New York Philharmonic under Toscanini, in the NBC Symphony under Toscanini, played in the New York Fair, played in the Chicago. He changed how tuba was looked at. I actually shook hands with him, met him. When you shook hands, I have fairly good sized hands, and they just evaporated. He was a huge man, a great big man, and a monster on our instrument. He was born on Christmas Eve, and I think died on Christmas Day. I don't remember just how that all works out, but he was a very devout Lutheran, and his favorite Lutheran chorale was Komm süßer Tod, or Come Sweet Death. When this Tuba Christmas was put together, Harvey Phillips insisted that the favorite Lutheran chorale of Bill Bell be part of this book. It's extremely difficult for us to do. It's in the high range for everybody. It's truly a killer. And a lot of Tuba Christmases don't ever play it because it's not very much in the Christmas spirit, Come Sweet Death. But if you are indeed a Christian, that message should be strong for you, because that's what the book says. Come Sweet Death, that's when it gets better. And it's in our book, and we're always a good playing group, and we're going to play it for you right now. You may not feel at the end of it like applauding, or you may. It's up to you. It isn't something that you just jump up and say, oh wow, about. Just listen to the beauty of this piece. An old Lutheran chorale, Come Sweet Death, or Komm süßer Tod. Christmas piece, Deck the Halls. Second time through, Janet will get you singing. When Lynn and Mabel were still alive, one time out here afterwards, I guess it was at Jezebel's. Lynn and Mabel were standing off to the side. Lynn and Mabel Slayton, some of you knew them, good friends of Janet's and mine. somebody was kind of saying, oh, Bill, oh my, Mr. Long, that was so wonderful, that was so great. And Mabel said, as only Mabel could say it, I don't see that at all. It's Janet that does it all. And as I recall, Lynn said, yeah. So, Janet, that was beautiful. Thank you.
Kiss it. I'll give you four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Probably
half of your favorites, if it isn't Silent Night, this probably is one of them, the First Noel. It's going to be a real long session.
It's all about you guys. How many different kinds of instruments are up here?
How many?
Different kinds of instruments.
Oh, how many different kinds of instruments? Okay, all of the euphoniums, Brandon, hold up a euphonium. That's actually, if you grew up in France, that's called the tenor tuba. That's part of the reason that there's a connection there. It's called a tenor tuba or a euphonium. They are either a three-valved horn, like we're going to have, Judah, if you'll hold up a three-valved horn, that's a three-valved horn, and then he has a four-valved horn over here. But they're all the same. One is more expensive than the other. Then it gets interesting in the back. Oh my goodness. Clear over there on your left are sousaphones. Guys, would you hold those up so they can see them? They are actually what we use in the marching band field, but they're also a very, very nice instrument. Bill Bell played them all the time when he would go to concerts and so on because it was easier to project on them. They're a sousaphone. They're in the key of B-flat. They finger the same as most of the other tubas. John, hold up your B-flat. That's a four-valve B-flat tuba. That happens to be a very big one, a large bore instrument. And it's in the key of B-flat, so he has a set of fingerings. Then over here on my left, the most interesting instrument in this place. Tim Lawson, would you hold that instrument up, please? This is a 108-year-old York three-valve double E-flat tuba, which has an entirely different fingering system than any of the rest of us. He's all alone in the fingerings he used. They're not the same as any of us. And he got that for $600. I'm telling on him now. I would pay a lot more. I absolutely love the thing. Then clear over on your right, Payne is playing a double C tuba, and that has entirely different fingerings from anybody else in here. That's very, well, Julian, you're playing double C too, aren't you? Okay, both of you guys are, and they're all, those three guys have one set of fingerings. Then back here with me, Jeremy and I have F tubas, and again, the two of us have an entirely different fingering system. Oh, my chops are coming back. Thank you, madam. Okay, so that's the situation, and a few years ago, we had a guy from Atlanta that had a double bell euphonium. And I actually seriously tried to buy it, but he didn't want to sell it. And I've only seen one or two of those in my life. A double bell, and they have another, there are two bells on the things. So anyway, enough of that. O come, O come, Emmanuel. You get to sing? No, they don't.
Well,
we just take it one time down, don't we, Jenny?
Yes. If you know the words, go ahead, but I can't help you there.
Second engine.
Okay.
1, 2, 3. It's not a real good singing key, but
That's all right. Do whatever you can. All right, so here's Silent Night, next to last piece. Thank you all for coming. We've got a lot of joy in this place right now. Thank you for coming. We have one more piece for you, and then the people are going to have to get their horns put away and so on, and then you can have at them and do whatever you're going to do. So we really appreciate it, and Tubas and Euphoniums, you have no idea how heartwarming this is for me, and to get to see people like Hannah coming back, and to get to see people like Jesse coming back, and the people that aren't even up here, Zach, I don't get to see these people that used to be in my band, and sometimes, you know, instead of being all full of joy, I almost feel like bawling. Oh my God, there's Jesse Palmer, it's overwhelming to me, so I thank you, and I thank all you people up there. Margaret, you may not be the oldest next year, but we want you back now. Faye, are you coming back? Okay. All right. Okay. So here we go with Jingle Bells, and thank you so much, audience. Foster, how are you? Good to see you, man.
And we'll sing.
Huh?
I'm telling you that we're going to sing. This is your last chance now, Belton. You have been incredible. I'm not kidding myself. I think this is the best singing group we've had. I really mean that. It's just been wonderful. Make some fun. Make some fun up here for us. Okay. surprising.
Thank you. have two problems. These guys are so cool. They're throwing out their butter and salt. They were really good, man.
Just like
they played. It was very good. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
We went to
go there.
Ruby, I thought was like better than the original prize there.
It's not the same.
I didn't even finish it. I watched more of
them. I think it's just meant to be
nice. In the old times, it provides you the age of your life. I was like,
Who else has a band? There's a bunch of authors. Stephen King.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Dave Barry. Amy Tan. I saw him in concert. You know, when he was big in the 70s. He played banjo some, but.
I got it.
so I can practice that
Okay.
get stressed when I'm suffering. One time. Go back there on Friday.
Obviously, we shouldn't be, but it's hard to feel. you don't have the money to buy a book at that time, it's harder to have you come here and not play. You know what I'm saying? So, if you are playing off of copy business, it must go back to the ladies at the desk, okay? John needs to take it back to the ladder. Just, I don't know who that is. Okay? All right.
You can talk if you want to. Like a church in here.
We're afraid we might miss what you're listening to.